Hey students, what we are going to study today is about BMI, that is Body Mass Index, Human Development Index and Sustainability of Development. Students, if adults are undernourished, there is a way to calculate it, that is Body Mass Index. It is used to find out whether a person is nourished, undernourished or overweight. But how can we calculate body mass index? It is very simple way to calculate it. First, we take the weight of a person in kg, then height in meter. Then divide weight of a person by height and its square, means divide weight of a person by the square of his height. Then we get body mass index. If this figure is less than 18.5, then the person would be considered undernourished. And if it is more than 25, then a person is overweight. Between 18 to 25 is nourished. This is the three categories to decide the person is nourished, undernourished or overweight. There is an exception also here is that growing children are not evaluated on BMI, body mass index. So this is about a body mass index. Next, Human Development Report. That is Human Development Index. Human Development Index published by United Nations Development Program, UNDP. It compares countries based on the education levels of the people, their health status and per capita income. On the basis of these three criteria, Human Development Index is calculated. And it is published by UNDP, United Nations Development Program. And it would be more interesting to look at certain relevant data regarding India and its neighbors from Human Development Report. According to the Human Development Report of 2006, some data is given which is related to the neighboring countries of India. Let's have a look at it. See the countries: Sri Lanka, India, Myanmar, Pakistan, Nepal, and Bangladesh. These are the countries given. What are the things given? Per capita income in US dollars, life expectancy at birth, literacy rate, gross enrollment ratio, and World Human Development Index rank. And this rank has been taken out of 177 countries. How many countries? 177. See, per capita income of Sri Lanka, that is $4,390, whereas India, $3,139, Myanmar, $1,027, Pakistan, $2,225, Nepal, $1,490, Bangladesh, $1,870. Now, life expectancy. What is life expectancy? It is the lifespan of a person, means number of years one person has to live at the time of birth. That is life expectancy. So the life expectancy of an average Sri Lankan is 74 years, whereas it is 64 years only in India. This is according to the Human Development Report of 2006. In Myanmar, 61, Pakistan, 63, then Nepal, 62, Bangladesh, 63. Now the third table is showing the literacy rate. Sri Lanka, 91, India, 61. Myanmar, 90, Pakistan, 50, Nepal, 50, Bangladesh, 41. See, in literacy, as well as in life expectancy, the life expectancy as well as literacy rate of Sri Lanka, our neighboring country, a small island country, is far ahead of us. The literacy rate of Sri Lanka is 91, whereas India is only 61. And their life expectancy is 74. Ours is 64 only. And gross enrollment ratio also, Sri Lanka is ahead of us, 69. And in world rank, its rank is 93. Out of 177 countries, human development index rank, Sri Lanka stood at 93, whereas India is 126 only. See where India stands in human development rank. And what is the criteria for this rank? This is on the basis of per capita income, literacy rate, and health status of the people. You know, health status of the people shows their life expectancy. In all these criteria, Sri Lanka is ahead of us. Sri Lanka is far ahead of us. India is India stands behind Sri Lanka for this. And, you know, in Nepal, though their per capita income is just half of us, but their life expectancy rate is not so far behind of us. See, their life expectancy is 62, whereas ours is 64. See the difference. So, from this table, it is very clear that Sri Lanka is going ahead, or their performance in per capita income, literacy rate, gross enrollment ratio, all these things are higher than ours. Isn't it surprising you that a small country in our neighborhood, Sri Lanka, is much ahead of India in every respect? A big country like ours has such a low rank in the world. So this table that teaches that what is important in life, that is, or what is important in development is people, their health, their well-being are more important. See, these three things are more important in our life. People, their health, and their well-being. Now, we will move to our next topic, sustainability of development. Sustainability of development. I quote, in this context, we have not inherited the world from our forefathers. We have borrowed it from our children. The quote is very important here because it stresses on sustainable development. Students, what is sustainable development? It is the development without hampering the needs of the future generations. Means, it is a concept of durable development carried out by limiting the needs of the present so that the future generations may enjoy the benefits of nature to the fullest. We are not inherited the resources which we use today from our forefathers. We are borrowed it from our children. So we have to preserve it for our children. We cannot utilize fully and we have to preserve for them. See, it is to be successful. Sustainable development can be achieved fully if we limit the needs of our present. It does not mean that we do not use any resources currently. We can use resources, but we avoid overuse of any kind of resources because we have to keep it for our future generations. Renewable resources like groundwater are replenished by nature. The situation of groundwater is also very pathetic now. it is continuously depleting. You know, this groundwater are replenished by nature, but because of overuse of these things, that is also be depleted. Here, now let's have a look at the tree diagram of sustainable development. Tree diagram of sustainable development. From this diagram, it is more clear that what are the conditions required for this development. However, since the second half of the 20th century, a number of scientists have been warning that the present type and levels of development are not sustainable. Many of the scientists already warned what we do today is not for development. The present levels of development are not sustainable. Some examples will make you clear that sustainable development is the need of the time. It is the urgent need of the time. Do you know the total estimated groundwater depletion in India is in the range of 122 to 199. Yes, 122 to 199 billion meter cube. That is the total estimated groundwater depletion in India. Among these regions, Western India, Indo-Gangetic Plain account for most intensive groundwater based on irrigation. Because of irrigation, Western India, Indo-Gangetic Plain, Northern Plains, they intensively use groundwater for irrigation because that areas are agriculture belts of India. Agriculture is mainly based on irrigation. That we saw in Green Revolution. More irrigation, more crops because of the utilization of fertilizers. Irrigation is required. These regions have more than 90% of the area irrigated during groundwater, using groundwater. These areas, Western India, Indo-Gangetic Plain, using groundwater for irrigation. Based on Central Groundwater Board, CGWB, Central Groundwater Board data, a majority of districts in India experienced a significant depletion in groundwater storage. So this Central Groundwater Board given a data that shows that a significant depletion in groundwater storage. Let's see. Districts with a significant decrease in groundwater are located in the Indo-Gangetic Plain, Northwest India, and Central regions, that is Maharashtra regions, and a few districts in Punjab also. So these areas utilizing groundwater excessively for agriculture, irrigation. With the depletion occurring at a rate of 91 centimeter per year, the speed of depletion per year, 91 centimeter depletion, Punjab has been witnessing a steep decline in groundwater table. If the depletion is continuing at this speed, result will be very disastrous. What is the result? If groundwater is depleted and the region experiences drought for 2 to 3 years continuously, there will be serious challenges. If it will be continued in such a speed, we should face some serious challenges, threats in our life. Availability of even drinking water will be a huge problem. Definitely, we will face shortage of drinking water. This is about depletion of groundwater. So, there should be an urgent need to preserve groundwater. For that, we need sustainable development. There should be sustainability in development. Another example is about exhaustion of natural resources. Crude oil reserves are also depleting. Do you know? If people continue to extract it at the present rate, the reserves would last only 43 years. More, only 43 years use will exist. Otherwise, you know that the resource will be exhausted. This is the data for the world as a whole. This is not for the data of India. This is the data for the world. However, different countries face different situations because the availability of crude oil to different countries are also different. So the situations of different countries are also different. Countries like India depend on importing oil because they do not have enough stocks of their own. So we depend on Middle East countries for oil, petroleum, crude oil. If prices of oil increases, this becomes a burden for everyone. So, we have to find any other alternative source of energy. Because this crude oil reserves are continuously depleting, this is a non-renewable resource. So, there is a need to preserve it for future generation also. Anyway, consequences of environmental degradation do not respect national or state boundaries. This issue is no longer region or nation specific. So, sustainability of development is a new area of knowledge in which scientists, economists, philosophers, and other social scientists are working together. All these people are working together in this field of sustainability of development. Because this is the urgent need and this is the need of the time. Hence, the question of development or progress is perennial. It is permanent. The chapter is over here. Revise the chapter with the help of assignment.